Investigators are trying to figure out what sparked a fire that destroyed a house in North Royalton. Firefighters were called to the house on Drake Road around 2:30 this morning. Four people living inside the house got out safely.
I think I fell asleep. You know, we were watching TV, laying down, and I fell asleep early. Or reading. I forget what exactly happened, but I remembered being woken up by Marcia, and she says, there's a fire in the garage. And I told her, I says, get everybody out of the house and call the fire department.
I'd fallen asleep, so when I woke up, I went to the kitchen, and I don't know why I went to the kitchen. People asked, you know, the fire marshals were asking me why I got up, and I said, well, I guess to get a drink of water. But after I went back in my bedroom, I realized my water was there, always next to me, my water. So I don't really know what prompted me. I believe it was the Holy Spirit or my guardian angel just woke me up and told me to go to the kitchen. My daughter had called 911, and they were there very fast. It didn't seem fast, but they were really there very fast. Police officers actually came first, and then there had to be 6 or 7 fire trucks there. Our neighbors all came.
They came out there, put a blanket over me.
And took us into their homes, and everybody's been wonderful.
And the policeman, he said, you know, come sit in the car. So I sat in the car for about 2 minutes, and I said, no, I have to get out. So I stood there for hours, and that smoke was blowing right at us.
And it just kept getting worse and worse. I have a strong foundation, and everybody I've dealt with in the last, this is Friday, this happened Monday morning, so we've been going through this process for these 5 days. And everybody I've encountered has said, you're really holding up well. You're really handling this well. And I would be a basket case. I keep hearing things like this. And I find that an opportunity to share my faith. Before I was saved, I was broken. And I'm just not that way anymore. I'm just so thankful for God's peace and His protection. And the Bible talks about beauty out of ashes. And I feel that's what He's done with me. I was lost in a pile of ashes before I accepted Jesus. And I know that that's why we were saved, because of our faith, and why we're handling this in that. Mm-hmm. And all these good people are put into our life this week. Our church family's been wonderful. I prayed for healing when I came to this church. It didn't happen immediately, but I can tell you the moment
it happened. Yeah.
I can tell you the moment it happened, and not everybody can experience that. I was touched by God or Jesus, finally answering my prayers. Maybe I don't want to say maybe I didn't pray hard enough or long enough. Maybe He was waiting for the right moment.
Right time.
I appreciate that so much, and I thank Him for that every day. And I'm thanking Him today for the protection of our family and our strong marriage.
And I have a warm wife that I can still hold.
The kitchen, the garage and the kitchen destroyed, unbelievably. The rest of the house was smoke damage. My kitchen table, which was the first piece of furniture we bought in 1975, an antique.
And put it in our new house, that was the only thing we owned. We slept on the carpet, and then we furnished the house, you know.
And the mirror,
and the
oak mirror.
Yeah.
So we bought these antique oak mirror, and they're black, and sitting there, and just, it was a very unique table. And I had a little, what is that, plaster? a plaque that says Jesus never fails. It's untouched. Amidst all that destruction, that thing is.
And there were other things on the walls. There was a key thing, and there were their pictures on this side.
Gone.
You know, just everything, no trace of anything except for that.
And if that doesn't speak to us or anybody,
subtle messages that you get, and it's just like, I'm here,
You're here because I'm here.
Yeah.